us, Michelle, with Michelle's Sunday Night Suppers. We're going to be making classic chicken pot pie from scratch tonight. So I'm going to go ahead and open our chicken. I'm going to pour it into our Paper Chef stoneware, and we're going to microwave the chicken. It's going to take about 8 minutes. These are a little bit bigger pieces. Trash all that. We don't have any salmonella. Salt and pepper on the top of our chicken. I'm going to add a little bit of water so it's not dry. And stick it in the microwave for 8 minutes and then we'll check it. Scratch. You don't use store-bought. You can use store-bought. There's nothing wrong with it. We just happen to make our own. Got our pie pan ready. Roll out our dough pretty thin. You don't have to use pie crust. You can use puff pastry as well. I just have pie dough on hand tonight, so that's what we're going to do. A little bit of flour on your surface and a little bit of flour on your rolling pin. And just roll her out. Alright, getting there. Gotta use a little bit of mussels. Off some of the flour. Bring our pan over. I'm going to put our crust right down in the bottom. Push it down. Alright, put that aside. We're going to roll out our top crust. Get the chicken in the microwave popping, but that's okay. Just means it's cooking. Use turkey as well. It doesn't have to be just chicken. You can mix it up. And I prefer my chicken pot pie with just carrots and peas, but you can put any kind of mixed vegetables in there. Today we're going to do it with peas and carrots. That's just what I prefer. A little bit more flour down. Oops. That went in the fork. We'll get that later. That's what the room was for. Alright, so we've got our top one rolled out. I'm going to go a little bit bigger. Making the filling, I'll just fold this one up and put it aside. Alright, now we're going to start with our filling. On a 2-quart saucepan, we're going to melt butter, a third of a cup of butter. I'm going to go ahead and add that into our saucepan. Turn our heat on. While that's melting, I have this little microwave cooker. I'm going to add our peas and carrots to it, just so we can get those in the microwave after the chicken comes out. You don't want to use frozen after everything is already cooked. I'm going to put a little bit of salt and pepper in there. Got to season your food really good so everything tastes good. Melting down. I'm going to go ahead and cut our onion up while I'm waiting.
big old knife.
Dice up a third of a cup of onion. And I don't measure, I just eyeball it. Peel off the skin. Graces with his presence. Go down big side and then start doing little slices. Now I'm gonna dice her up. Starting to melt. Almost there with the butter. I've got my oven preheated to 475. Just dice a little bit more. I like onion, but I like small pieces. Waiting on the chicken. Our butter is melted, so I'm going to add into our onion. So we'll start getting that soft. All right. And the chicken just went off, so we're going to check that as well. I'm trying to get all my onion in there. All my chicken pretty much in the microwave with this Pampered Chef stoneware. Let's see, look how juicy that still is. Who would have thunk? In the microwave, chicken. So it's still a little pink. So I'm gonna put it back in the microwave for 3 minutes and then we're gonna dice it up. On to our onions. I've got it on that medium heat. Bend up a little higher. Get an onion facial. Start to crack. It's pretty much ready. So we've got a third of a cup of flour we're going to add in to make a roux. Thicken up for our sauce so that our chicken can be nice and saucy. Alright, so we'll stir that in and cook the flour out because you don't want raw flour taste. Cook that for a minute, and then we're going to start adding our liquids. I have chicken stock. You can use broth, but stock's a little bit more flavorful, so that's what we're going to use today. So that's looking pretty good. Starting to get a little bit of color on it. So I'm going to add in half a cup of milk. Use 1 3/4 cups. or you can make your own homemade. It's up to you. We're going to use store-bought today. Noise, my dog's in the background playing with his ball. Can't really tell him to stop. Just chicken breast tenders. You can buy meat, the chicken that's already cut up, or turkey, whichever one you want, or you can get the whole breast and do it that way. Any cut of chicken works pretty well, whichever you prefer. You can even use chicken thighs. Use a lot of paper chef tools. They seem to be pretty good for us. Alright, so we've got all the chicken cut up. Clean it out of there. Just move this aside. Bubbly and getting thick. Our veggies just went off. I'm gonna grab them. I'm trying to strain it without burning myself, see if there's any excess water in there, because we don't want that. We don't want the extra water in our sauce. So I'm gonna switch out from a whisk.
Like I said, you can use any kind of vegetable. You can use the corn, string beans, peas, carrots, whatever you like.
I'm gonna add in the chicken.
Just be careful because it's still hot.
If you don't have homemade pie crust, you can use store-bought or puff pastry works really well too. You just gotta cook it a little bit higher, temperature a little bit longer to get it nice and crispy. But it is really good for chicken pot pie. I'm gonna put our top crust on. I'm not a big crust person, so I'm going to cut off a lot of the crust. I'm more of a filling person. So I'm going to cut these edges off. And then you can use the extra bake it off with a little bit of cinnamon and sugar, but I'm just going to throw them away today. I'm just going to fold them under. Chief wants to make his debut playing ball in the house when we're trying to cook here. So I'm just going to crimp the edges a little bit. And there he is. Put a couple holes, vent holes in the top. Take the gloves off, and then she's going to go in the oven for roughly 35 to 40 minutes, depending on your oven. So, here she goes. Alright, and here's your chicken pot pie. Fresh out of the oven. Tune in next week to see what we have cooking on Michelle's Sunday Suppers.